Kouassi Atta is the founder of Focus Organization, an award-winning company aiming to bring good music to the masses. He joins me in the studio with Mohammed Yaaya, who's one half of Native Sun, a London-based musical duo that fuses hip-hop and African rhythms to promote the messages of peace, equality, social justice and environmental change. Well, they're both taking part in the London African Musical Festival, which kicks off this Friday, and we're going to talk about it. But before we chat, let's get a flavour of the music. What we're going to listen to is Senses by Native Sun.
Put your troubles away. It's so easy to carry the world on your shoulders all day, but let it go. Just let it go. Take the stones of your face in this cold-hearted place, bring the heat. Lift your hands, love your life, feel good vibes, and move your feet, dance to the beat.
Gentlemen, a very good morning. I was tapping my foot to that. You've been nodding your head for approval. Yeah. It's wonderful. It's lovely. And it totally defies the perception of hip-hop, I suppose.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for having us.
So where was the video shot?
So that video was actually shot in Mexico. We were touring last year in America and in Mexico with an amazing collective called Quilombo Art. And while we were there, we just decided to really capture the essence of that trip. And we connected with an amazing filmmaker called Cambio, and we shot the video.
And it all just happened.
Yeah, everything was like, a lot of the things that you actually seen in the video were actually taking place for the first time, so it was really organic.
Okay. I mean, how did you two connect? Who found whom?
We just connect because we promote musical events, and we manage some artists, and the first time we launched your album.
That's right.
First album, yes.
Yeah.
When they came up with this beautiful album, we say, okay, let's team up and put on a real show and let people appreciate, enjoy your music.
So yeah. It does seem a bit mean in some ways to describe you as a musical promoter, because what you do and your vision is so much bigger than that, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, yeah, definitely, definitely. We started with promoting the music, then we had a diversity of activities, producing records, which is the soundtrack of a film coming up in October, has already been nominated for an award. And we have some arts. Our artist, a painter, has been nominated for the Artist of the Year 2014. So many things, everything positive, everything to promote the African culture, African music. Focus is there.
Right, well, it just sounds like you've been scratching the surface of what you do, but yeah, I mean, yeah. You got a pretty good picture. But I mean, let's take it back to your music, Mohammed, because I mean, you saw Serena there.
That's right.
In that video. She's got a magnificent voice. I mean, how did you realise that she was the person who you needed to collaborate with? What was it that drew you to her?
I mean, we've had this amazing friendship for 12 years. So, and it wasn't until around 3.5 years ago that we decided to come together and work on a track. But as soon as we worked on that track, we knew that there was this beautiful chemistry of friendship and experiences that we both could bring into the table. And from that one track, it turned into 3 tracks. And the next thing you know, we had an album. It wasn't something that we specifically planned, but it was just like really organic way, and it just felt positive.
So, but what was the turning point? Because you said you've known each other for a long time. It's only 3.5 years ago that you guys got it together.
I think it's because we were just focusing on individual projects. At the time, Serena was a solo artist. I was part of other groups. And for a while, I had this idea of creating hip-hop music, but really having the African influence into it. And I just like the sound and the idea of having a male rapper and a female singer, just to have that combination, you know. And you know, Serena, I felt really comfortable with her, and I really liked her music, so we just decided to work on that one track, and it felt comfortable, and that was it.
I mean, I've spoken to a number of African musicians since I've been doing this program, and what never fails to amaze me is how the music is really catching on. with a wider audience, that you've got the traditional African music and then you've also got musicians like yourself who are fusing it with other influences like hip-hop, like rap, whatever. I mean, how difficult was it to actually get people to actually say, listen, stage an event which does this at your venue? Because that initial skepticism must have been really irritating, quite frankly.
Yeah, at the beginning it was a bit challenging. It was a bit challenging in venues, but right now we have found some artists who work hard, like Native Sound, Kazamasai, Mensa, Mutuvaldo, some guys that really worked so hard, professional. So we work with them, closely with them, and we put on some great, great shows. People came, they enjoyed it, and I think starting to grow. So now the public, the audience is really big.
Sure.
Yeah, all over London, all over UK, I think, all over the world right now. Yeah.
But I mean, initially though, when people said, oh, we don't really think you're suitable here, so to speak, or what you're offering me, what was the typical excuse they gave for turning you away?
Okay, I can't answer for them, but with the new generation of Afrobeat, everything became
it
so fashion.
It always comes back to Afrobeat.
Now the African music is so fashion. Everyone wants to be related to Ghana, to Nigeria, to
or claiming to a African relationship that might not exist.
So everything has evolved, and we've been working really hard to change, to promote. That was our aim, to promote a positive image of Africa and African music. With this result, it's a big achievement for all of us.
Yeah. And you're succeeding, and certainly what you do really stresses that message. I mean, what are your plans? Because you've done one album, and you've got another one which you're developing at the moment. Is that correct?
That's right. We're working on a new album called Mother Tongue, and we're hoping to release it in March next year. But actually, next month we'll be releasing the first single from that album.
Okay, now time is running very, very tight, but in the time that's available, can you tell us about the festival in terms of when it's happening and where?
Oh, the 12th London African Music Festival will be happening from this Friday, 19th of September, until the 28th of September in 16 venues, more than 100 artists over 10 days. And the main one, our focus event, a specific focus event with the Native Sound, the 26th of this month at Passing Clouds. And another event for us, the first ever Best of Black British Business Expo at Hilton Olympia, the 28th from 11 to 8. You can't miss it.
Excellent. So go on the web as well if there's anything you need to know.
Yeah, focusorganization.com is the place, and I have a gift for you.
Oh, thank you.
Focus Africa. This is for you.
That's wonderful. No Focus Africa. So don't forget it. Focus Africa. That's brilliant. Gentlemen, thank you so much.
Thank you.
And good luck with the kickoff and, of course, with the album. But thank you.
Thank you very much for having us here.
Brilliant.
Stay focused, guys.